given the honor of officiating this special day, which is a fairly humbling thing. I'm not sure what qualifies me, but it's truly an honor. We are gathered here to celebrate the relationship of Elizabeth and Matthew and to be witnesses and supporters of their commitment today for each other. This is a special day. It is an important day that will live forever in memory. Elizabeth and Matthew have asked me to express their gratitude to you, their friends and family, for being here to witness and celebrate in their joy. Elizabeth and Matthew would also, we would like to, by modern age of electronics, welcome some people via live stream, but we didn't quite get that rolling. So we have been, we'll be videoing this and we'll give it to JoJo and Bob and also the Bowmans and any others who would like to watch the ceremony afterwards. Marriage. If you want something to last forever, you treat it differently. You shield it and protect it. You never abuse it. You don't expose it to the elements. You don't make it common or ordinary. If it ever becomes tarnished, you lovingly polish it until it gleams like new. It becomes special because you have made it so. And it becomes more beautiful and precious as time goes by. I know this kind of sounds like Uncle Mary's girl. Marriage doesn't just happen by chance. A real marriage takes a lot of work. But I suspect you both know that by now. But that's the tedious part, and we want to focus on exciting for today. You'll get back to reality tomorrow. Who gives this man to be married today?
We did.
And who gives this woman to be married today?
We did.
In marriage, it's the little things that are the big things. It's being never So before I pronounce you, I have just one more thing I want you to do. Your wedding day is one that seems to fly by. It is a day filled with emotion, friends, rings, dances. So I want you guys to take a second and look into each other's eyes. Think about the happiness that you're feeling in this place, right now, in this moment. Now really let that feeling register in your heart and mind. Now I want you to think about what your life will be like in 20 years. Where are you? What are you doing? Your visions of the future aren't identical, but I promise you, they're complementary. John Lennon once said, "A dream you dream alone is only a dream. A dream you dream together, that is reality. That new reality